Hello, Pisces. Welcome to another love reading. This one will be all about what you and the person you're thinking about feel about each other. What are the energies between you? And what can you expect in the near future? Keep in mind that these readings are general, so they cannot and will not resonate with every Pisces watching. Take what resonates for you, what applies for you. If you find that it doesn't resonate much for you, check out the Pisces playlist. It's linked in the description box, and there's a ton of videos there for your sign. All right, Pisces, let's jump right in. Spirit, angels, guides. What messages, what guidance do you have for Pisces? For Pisces spirit, regarding the person they are thinking about or connecting with at this time, what do we need to know about this connection? The energies between Pisces and this other person. We need to know about the energies between Pisces and this other person. Okay, let's see what we have for you. Overall energy, the Magician with the Ten of Wands. On your side, we have the Queen of Wands and the Empress, and on their side, the Devil and the Ace of Pentacles. Capricorn energy here with the Devil. Interesting. Where all of this is headed next. Overall energy, the Sun. With the Magician and the Ten of Wands, I feel like someone's trying to work out or make something happen with an existing burden, an existing issue, problem, etc. Let's see what else we need to know. Spirit, tell me more about the energies here between Pisces and this other person. It seems like your person wants to make you some sort of an offer here with the Ace of Pentacles, some sort of proposal or opportunity they want to have here with you. And maybe there is something here that is part of that manifesting energy, right? Like maybe one of you is manifesting this offer, but I think there's a burden in the way here. Okay, there's happy ending. What are the energies between Pisces and this other individual? What do we need to know, Spirit? Cold shoulder and breathe in. Interesting. When I see cold shoulder with breathe in, or any card with really like breathe in or cold shoulder, I think of like silence, quiet energy. Maybe there's not a lot of communication, or maybe someone's not really taking action right now, just thinking, reflecting on what they want to do. New beginnings is at the bottom of the deck. So let's get to clarifying this energy for Pisces. What do we need to know? Oops. We need to know, Spirit. Can we get some clarity, please, on this energy? Okay, I keep dropping my cards. There's a Magician again. Okay, let's start with the Magician. Spirit, why is the Magician here? The Eight of Swords. Okay. Tell me more about the Magician. Queen of Swords. Okay, so I feel like this is somebody that is trying to make something happen with the Magician. And maybe it requires overcoming some sort of fear. The Queen of Swords is kind of fearless. She reminds me of the Queen of Wands sometimes, because there's nothing getting in the way between her and the truth. Nine of Cups is at the bottom of the deck. So maybe this is somebody that needs to communicate something. Maybe they need to figure something out. Maybe they need to use their intellect, their analytical skills, their logic, their communication skills to deal with some sort of stuck energy or some sort of fear, to manifest something here, to manifest their Nine of Cups, which is like a wish granted. Tell me more about the magician. Why is the magician here, spirit? That one flipped over. Nine of swords. So there's something here about fear. Someone is scared. Three of cups. Maybe this is like wanting to come together, reunite with someone, and there's like a fear of it not happening. Or maybe this is somebody that wants to talk about coming together, but they're very scared. Why is the sun here? Why is the sun here, spirit? Why is the sun here? The Ace of Pentacles. So I feel like this is an offer that someone really wants to make, an opportunity they want to have, an opportunity for happiness. I'm also getting that someone would be very happy to hear about this. Yeah, Eight of Wands. There's some sort of offer being extended here, and I think the other person is very happy to receive that offer. So what's with the Ten of Wands? Why is the Ten of Wands here? I think the Ten of Wands is reminding me of this devil energy. Eight of Pentacles. Okay, what else about the Ten of Wands? What else do we need to know about the Ten of Wands? The Emperor, Aries energy. And then there's the Knight of Pentacles. So I feel like someone needs to work through a burden or an obligation in order to make this happen. It's taking time with the Knight of Pentacles. This burden could be anything. It could be an unhealthy attachment. It could be the baggage from the past, some sort of difficulty that someone has been carrying for some time. And the Emperor is a doer. The Magician, they're doers. They make things happen. And the Emperor is very focused on stability, having control of a situation, taking charge. I also find it fascinating that you have the Empress here on your side, Pisces. So these are divine counterparts for me. These are people that are meant to be together. They make a great couple. They make a great partnership. So then let's jump into both of your energies here and get some insight. Spirit, can I get some insight, please, for Pisces? What do we need to know about the energies between Pisces and this other person? Tell me about Pisces. Journey, okay. This is traveling, transitions, moves that you're making, like moving from place to place. Tell me about Pisces, this person, the person Pisces is dealing with. What do we need to know about them? False person? Wealthy man. Okay, so I feel like this could be the classic case of someone just not sharing how they truly feel here. Because we have cold shoulder as well. We'll see. Tell me more, spirit. For Pisces. Tell me more for Pisces, please. What do we need to know? What do I need to know for Pisces? Tell me about this person that Pisces is dealing with. What are they thinking or feeling about Pisces, spirit? I'm starting to understand our connection. Okay. Bottom of the deck, I wish I had treated you better. Okay, so there's a little bit of regrets here. Tell me about Pisces. What do we need to know about Pisces? I'm so attracted to you. Pisces, I feel like what I see here is almost like this could be what this person's telling you, but I'm also getting that you're very drawn to this person. Maybe your mind wanders back to this person when you're like least expecting it to. I feel like you think about them, you think about this connection. Queen of Wands is showing up on your side here. This is someone that's bold. Fearless almost. Bottom of the deck, I love you. So you might have a lot of feelings for this person. So let's jump into your energies here. Spirit, tell me about the Queen of Wands. Why is the Queen of Wands here? Nine of Pentacles. So you look great. You're someone to be admired. You're someone that has a lot going for you, Pisces. Maybe you're doing really well at work or with a personal business. Maybe you're doing really well financially. Maybe you've just found stability, are dressing better, looking better, treating yourself better here. The Queen of Wands and the Nine of Pentacles, to me as a reader, those two energies together, it's like this person has it all. They have the looks, but also they have the stability, right? They work hard. They're adventurous, fun, etc., etc. Tell me about the Queen of Wands, please. Seven of Swords. I feel like this person's watching you, observing you. They did not appreciate you, is what I'm getting here. Now I'm starting to understand why I wish I had treated you better came up, because you had it all and they still messed up, you know? What else could you have brought to this connection, you know? That's kind of what I'm getting here. Tell me about the Empress. Yeah, the Empress is at a different level. The Empress is someone that you think about as the ideal partner, the ideal parent, the ideal person that you just want to be around. They're very abundant. They manifest, they grow, they're beautiful, creative, etc., etc. They have the potential for, you know, so much more than just a typical person. Also, I'm getting some of you are business people, like boss, the boss babe hashtag, you know. You don't necessarily have to be a female, but you're doing very well for yourself. Two of Swords, Page of Wands. Yeah, I feel like you are, yeah, Ace of Cups. I think that someone is just completely like into you and not wanting to come forward, not knowing what to do. I'm also getting that you are at a threshold yourself, perhaps here. Maybe you've been dating some people with Page of Wands. The Page of Wands to me is like the person that puts themselves out there, does things like dating and meeting out, going out with friends and all of that. But I feel like this is more your person. Your person is a Page of Wands and you are an Empress energy. You are the Queen of Wands, right? Like there's no comparison. This Two of Swords is reminding me of all this fear. The Nine of Swords, Eight of Swords. They know that they love you. Ace of Cups is here, right? But it's almost like if they didn't treat you better back then, you're definitely going to be expecting it now if you're in this energy. And will you even be into them? What's this Two of Swords about? Let's double check. Tell me about the Two of Swords, Spirit. Why is the Two of Swords here? Why is the Two of Swords here? The Knight of Swords. Yeah, I feel like this is about talking to you. There's a Knight of Wands at the bottom of the deck. Whatever move they want to make towards you, this person's almost like stuck or undecided about what to say, what to do. Because they have to face an Empress. Tell me about the Devil. Why is the Devil here? Okay. Queen of Pentacles, Ten of Wands shows up again, Three of Pentacles. So this person could be in an unhealthy attachment of some sort. Maybe they are workaholics. Page of Pentacles. I feel like they're stuck somewhere. Now, the Queen of Pentacles, to me as a reader, they tend to already be in a long-term commitment. That's why I'm wondering if this person is somewhere else. But I also get the sense that this person is maybe, you know, I'm getting a lot of messages, but one of the messages I see is someone really working hard to get to a specific place in their life. I think that they haven't gone about it the right way. You know, some of you are dealing with someone who they thought that whatever they were working on, wherever they were at, whatever career they started, whatever person they decided to be with, that would have gotten them to a certain level, and it hasn't. It's been very difficult, and I think also this person might feel stuck there because all this time was spent there. Ten of Wands is here. Ten of Wands with the Eight of Pentacles, Ten of Wands with the Three of Pentacles. So very similar energies. Three of Pentacles, Eight of Pentacles. These are energies about work, effort, time put into something. I also get the sense that this person might be playing catch up here because this Queen of Pentacles is reminding me of this Nine of Pentacles, right? Someone with a lot of value, someone that has a lot to offer, someone that looks great, is again business oriented. Queen of Pentacles would be like an entrepreneur, Hashtag boss babe, like I was saying. But now I'm starting to wonder if this is more like a drive this person has to address this Ten of Wands. Can I get one more for this devil energy? Why is the devil here? Why is the devil here? Strength. Leo energy. Strength. Courage. Ten of Swords at the bottom of the deck. Interesting. I feel like with strength here, strength is really a card about using a different approach to get to a certain result. Talk soft, carry a big stick. That's the energy there. Use inner strength to do that. You don't use force. You don't have to use force with strength. I think your person is trying to figure something out with this Ten of Wands. This Ten of Wands will be different for all of you. But they're like trying to work, I think, a little bit too much on this. Tell me about the Ace of Pentacles. Nine of Cups, Ten of Swords again. Tell me about the Ace of Pentacles. Something here about like an ending, completion. I have Ten of Wands, Ten of Swords. Tens are about completion. Justice, Libra energy. Okay, so with Justice and the Nine of Cups, I'm getting like someone's like, this is what I deserve. Ace of Cups at the bottom of the deck. This offered, this Ace of opportunity, this is what I deserve. I'm also getting that this person with the Justice card and the Ten of Swords, maybe they want to fix an ending here, rebalance an ending, make things right. Let's see, where is all of this headed? We'll see. What's next for this connection? Four of Wands, the Lovers, wow, Gemini energy, and the Four of Pentacles. Okay, so the Four of Pentacles to me is, especially here, I'm getting holding on rather than holding back, but let me clarify. Tell me about this Four of Pentacles. Why is the Four of Pentacles here? Four of Pentacles, okay. Why is the Four of Pentacles here, Spirit? Four of Cups. Okay, so this might be holding back. Why is the Four of Pentacles here? Why is the Four of Pentacles here? Five of Wands, and then the King of Swords. Okay, so when I see the Four of Pentacles with the Four of Cups, I think of someone that might be holding back because of rejection, because the Four of Cups is like someone that does not take a cup that's being offered to them. They can't really see it. They're not open to new opportunities. So that could be the case there, that they might not want to be rejected. But I'm also getting with these two energies that it could be that someone's holding on with the Four of Pentacles, holding on to something and not open to anything else, right? Four of Pentacles here again. Five of Wands. This is interesting because I feel like this card is all about conflict, drama, fighting. I think your person is like expecting some sort of struggle here, some sort of conflict or drama, but I'm not sure why. Maybe there was drama, conflict between you in the past. Maybe they think that rejection will come because of that. Can I get one more for this Four of Pentacles? Three of Swords. Yeah, so I feel like something happened here between you and this person. There's something in your history that was very difficult. And now your person wants to balance it out. Six of Pentacles. I feel like they're going to be coming forward here. But I don't see action in any of these cards. So it's like someone has the intent here. They might be manifesting this, but they're not really doing anything about it just yet. Tell me about the Four of Wands and the Lovers. Tell me about the Four of Wands and the Lovers, please, for Pisces. Ace of Swords. So yeah, I see more communication than action here. I think this person might be opening the lines of communication or wanting to talk things out with you. I think this has to do with the past. They might tell you that, you know, they feel a strong connection with you, the Lovers. they have been undecided about this because the Two of Swords showed up with the Knight of Swords. I think this person is intimidated by you, to be honest. What else do we need to know about this person that Pisces is dealing with? What else? Let's get a secret moon here. What do we need to know about this person that Pisces is dealing with? I see forever with you. What else do we need to know for Pisces? It's all my fault. Yep. They know that whatever happened between you, they lost big. That's what I'm seeing here. And now they're intimidated by what you have become. Because now I feel like a lot of you have been on your own personal journey. Maybe you've changed, grown, matured. Maybe your business is doing great. Maybe you are doing great. I feel like this person, they invested in the wrong thing, whatever that may be. I feel like it didn't take them where they thought they would be taken, right? And so I feel like they're trying to come back here. They're starting to understand something about your connection, and maybe you're the one that got away, Pisces. So that's what I have for you. Hopefully you enjoyed this reading. Let me know in the comments if you did. Like the video if you enjoyed how I read, if it resonated for you. Subscribe if you haven't already. I would love to have you. And I will see you all in another video very soon. Take care.